Tomoyo, wake up!
My stomach hurts. I'm staying home.
You've already used that excuse twice this week.
You don't have to come over every morning. I keep telling you that.
I can't just ignore the problem. I'm your girlfriend. This is my job.
Well, let's break up.
That's not funny. Don't even joke about that, okay? Even if you're kidding, it still makes me sad.
Come on, don't give me that face. I take it back. Hey, today's the day of the student council elections, right? This is no time to be down.
Yeah, you're right. I'll give it my best.
Should be out soon. Shouldn't you be back in your classroom?
Maybe, but I feel calmer here with you.
It's been a month since I started dating Tomoyo. It wasn't really planned or anything. It just sort of happened. When I first met her, I was always cut in class. Even when I did come to school, I was late. But somehow, after getting to know her better, not only did I start coming to school on time, I started falling in love with her as well.
The results of the student council elections have now been calculated. The new student body president is Tomoyo Sakagami, winning with 533 votes.
I couldn't have done it without your support.
Anyway, this is where the real fight begins. Getting elected is just the first step in protecting the cherry trees.
Don't worry, I know. Tomoyo, you'll stay with me from now on too, won't you?
Wouldn't have it any other way.
Congratulations on winning the election!
Hi, Sakagami! I'm so glad you're the new president.
Thanks, that means a lot.
We knew you could do it. We'll always be cheering.
The three of us make a pretty weird combination, don't you think? Two senior slackers and the president of the student council? It's like we're not even living in the same world.
Those two are the biggest punks in the school. What are they doing hanging around with Sakagami?
I have no idea. But she seems to be on good terms with them, at least.
Yeah. But she's the president now. You really think she'll show?
Of course she's gonna show. She's come every other day, hasn't she?
Pretty laid back, aren't you?
Why's that?
Just think for a sec. She's the student council president now. She's gonna be way more demanding of you than she was before. No running in the hallways. Eat three meals with lots of veggies and don't leave the faucets running. No way! I'm not ready to grow up yet!
Hey, what's with all the yelling?
Tomoyo? I'll show you who's boss! I'm gonna eat all my vegetables! Just you wait!
I never know what's going on in his head.
Nothing.
I guess you're right, huh?
Don't agree with him!
I just came by to drop these off. I have a council meeting today, so I better split. See ya!
Bye!
Look at that. Busy already.
Guess so.
That's nice. She made lunch for me, too. Now, let's try to figure out which one is which. Too obvious!
What kind of relationship does he have with somebody?
I'm not sure, but they seem pretty close, don't you think?
Don't tell me they're going out!
No way. Hey, shh.
What are you punks looking at? She's late. What's her deal?
It's no surprise since she was busy at lunch, too. Oh, well, I'll wait a little bit longer.
Tomoya. I'm sorry, but going home without...
It's Tomoyo.
I forgot that I have a school festival meeting today. We're running behind, so it'll probably be late in the evening when we get out.
The intercom anyway, is for personal use. Turn it off.
That girl's a real catch, Tomoya. She's got balls of steel.
I hope it's not true, but some students are saying that you ran for this position on a whim. I took a look at your records from the previous school you attended. I hate to say it, Sakagami, but it seems like you were quite the troublemaker.
That's all in the past now.
Perhaps so, but that doesn't change the fact that Sakagami has caused a fair share of controversy at this school, too. Please don't misunderstand me. I'm not trying to tell you what to do. However, considering that you are our student council president, I think you should be both aware and watchful of the situation.
Yes, sir. It's okay. I don't blame him for being concerned. I know people are gossiping about us, and I had a feeling my old school record would catch up to me eventually. But the point is to focus on the future, not the past. Right, Tomoya?
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Right.
School festival, huh? I completely forgot that was coming up.
Tomoyo said she'll be hard-pressed for time till it's over.
Let's find something fun to do.
Huh?
Take a break from school. We could use one. We'll find some place to hang out on the way home. You have time now, right? Don't give me that face. Once school festival is out of the way, Tomoyo will have plenty of time to spend with us. Just us three, no student council.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
But if you ask me, I'd be a lot happier if I never had to see her face again. Hey, let's try talking to those girls over there. Come on, look, the one with the ponytail's cute. Hey, are you even listening to me? Huh? He's gone.
Must be hot in there.
Yeah, but... if they find out where I am, then they'll drag me back to the council room.
Are you guys really that busy?
Yeah, I'm in the middle of a campus patrol even now.
Don't stretch yourself too thin, all right?
Oh, don't worry, I'll be fine. Anyway, the reason I came here was to spend some time with you. I've been so busy with the festival that I've hardly had the chance to see you at all. And once the school festival is finally over, I'll probably end up spending all my time trying to preserve the cherry trees. Then things might get even worse than they are now. That's why.
Sakagami. I've been looking for you. The chairs of the alumni groups are waiting in the council room. Please hurry back.
Can't you wait until I finish my ice cream cone at least? It'll only be a second.
We've made them wait for 30 minutes already. If you want to preserve the cherry trees, we won't be able to do it without their support. We can't afford to upset them.
I understand. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Go give them hell.
I'll do my best.
You're Tomoya Okazaki, aren't you?
Watch how you talk to your upperclassmen, kid.
Maybe you don't realize it, but you've grown rather famous lately.
Why is that? Because I'm a good-for-nothing punk?
No, because you're Tomoyo Sakagami's boyfriend. There's something I've been meaning to tell you. I think you should stop hanging around her.
Oh, I get it. You're jealous, huh?
Not at all. Hmm? I suppose you could call it a special interest. To be blunt, I think she's someone who can go far in life. She's earnest and hardworking. Smart, too. She's someone with a tremendous amount of promise. That's why she needs to set her sights high. The point is, you're holding her back. Everyone knows it's true.
You little punk! You trying to pick a fight?
You know it. You know it too, don't you? You can't help her. You can only hold her back and hurt her. I'm leaving now. I have to help Sakagami with the alumni meeting.
Sakagami is very gifted. She's popular as well. And yet, she's friends with you, her total opposite, who frequently cuts classes and rarely comes in on time. And then, to make matters worse, she used the school intercom to contact you and abandoned her duties as council president just to meet with you. Do you understand the situation now? Might be hard to admit, but the problems she's caused are all related to you, Okazaki.
Tomoya! Hmm?
Hey! What's up?
Sorry, but something just came up. Can you go on ahead?
Is it really going to take that long?
I'm not sure, but probably.
Don't worry, I understand.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
All of this is your fault, you know.
Huh?
You know what's going on. How Sakagami has made her mission to preserve the cherry trees.
Yeah, I know. What about it?
One of the alumni we enlisted for help heard some nasty rumors about her. Supposedly, one of the students here caught Sakagami leaving her boyfriend's house early in the morning before school.
Huh? What does that matter? She just comes by to wake me up.
But this is you we're talking about. People won't believe that. Nasty rumors are bound to crop up. Sakagami is the student council president. She should serve as an example to the other students. If someone like that is the subject of controversy, it's going to be detrimental to our cause. You understand the situation, don't you? You realize what kind of person she is. And what kind of person you are.
It wasn't much of an emergency after all. All it took was a little meeting to clear up the misunderstanding. Anyway, it's all over now, okay? Spacing out, you're making a mess.
Tomoyo.
Huh?
Let's break up. I'm sorry, I just think it would be better that way, all right?
I told you, don't even joke about something like that.
You have goals you need to reach. Things you may not be able to accomplish if you have me holding you back. Okay, so just...
No. You can't!
Tomoyo...
No way!
Hear that? No, don't look. It's embarrassing.
If you don't have me, what are you going to do with yourself? If I'm not around, who's going to wake you up in the morning? Who's going to make your lunch every day? And if you have to study for a test, then what? And when you...
I'll be fine. I'll manage, okay? I'm sure I can do fine on my own.
But you...
If you stay, then before I know it, I'll be dependent on you for everything. That's not good for anyone.
But I'm still in love with you, Tomoya. I can't lose you.
Tomoyo. What I felt for you wasn't love, all right? I was being selfish, that's all. Just forget about me and live your dreams. I'm just proud that I was able to spend time with an amazing person like you. Let's leave it at that. Please, Tomoyo.
I understand. I'll do my best. Thank you for going out with a girl like me. I was happy. Take care.
Thank you.
here I thought you two were gonna get married after high school.
Sure, be nice if life was that simple.
But man, I always thought if she had to choose, she'd at least have the sense to pick you over the student council.
Who knows?
Hey, now that you don't have Tomoyo to hound you all the time, does that mean you're gonna go back to your old delinquent ways?
All right, so the next problem is just like example one.
For her volunteer work, too.
She might become a foreign exchange student, too.
I'm really gonna watch it, okay?
Do whatever you want.
Fine. I just thought you might not want to see it, that's all. Are you sure?
I said it's fine.
All right.
For the sake of our memories, we must protect these trees. Not only the memories of past generations, but the memories that will be formed by generations.
Some international conference about the cherry trees.
We can't become so wrapped up in our concept of progress that we destroy what made us who we are.
Must be the same presentation as the video.
Yeah.
Kind of hard to believe that we used to be friends with such an incredible girl, huh? Busy as usual.
Yeah. What's with your hair?
Stop laughing! I have a tough enough time just looking at myself in the mirror! But what was I supposed to do? It's not like I could show up at a job interview with blonde hair.
I guess you didn't fit their needs. But don't give up. I'm sure you'll find something. There are plenty of satisfying jobs out there for you, I promise.
The job I finally found ended up being in this town. It was a bit of a disappointment. I was hoping to be at least one train stop away.
Most of you are going on to college, and eventually you'll become an important part of society, with a career of your own. With that in mind...
Seriously? You mean you're leaving already? The celebrations aren't over yet.
Yeah, but I'm not interested. I'll stop by your place later.
Okay.
How have you been?
Okay. What's wrong?
I've been waiting for you. I wanted to tell you something.
What?
These cherry trees won't be cut down after all. It was finally settled.
I see.
It was a long fight, but it was something I couldn't give up on. Now it's finally happened.
You made your dream come true, huh?
But I lost something important along the way. Months I wanted to spend with the person I love. Time I can never have back. I still love you, Tomoya. I really do. And all this time, I've only grown to love you more.
How can you say that when we haven't spoken in so long?
Maybe not. But I've watched you all this time. I've still been here with you. Even without my help, you managed just fine. You always went to class on time, you worked hard every day, and you never gave up.
Yeah. although my lunch is one as good as yours. It certainly wasn't easy, but I looked for a job, too. Of course, thanks to my school record, a lot of doors were closed to me, but in the end, I finally landed a position. It's a recycling plant, a normal office job. Well, and the place is pretty close to here. It's still inside the town, actually, so there's no commute. That's it, I guess. Hey, what kind of things did we used to talk about? What did I say? How did I laugh? I can't seem to remember. We're on two separate paths now. You'll graduate next year, then you'll leave this town and go far away. You have the strength to do that. But I'm different. All I can do is stay here in this town, in the same place until I die. That's the kind of person I am.
If you can't go anywhere, then I'll come to you. I'll stay with you.
But why? You don't have to stay trapped in a miserable place like this. Go to a good college, meet wonderful people. Set your dreams high and make them come true. You can aim higher than this, Tomoyo, much higher. Don't waste your time staying grounded with me.
Don't say any more. I don't want to hear it, all right? I've already decided. Getting good grades and listening to teachers can take me somewhere high and far away. But what if that's not where I want to go? Right here, by your side, Tomoya, is the only place I want to be.
Who's the upperclassman here? I'll come. It's a bit late to say this, but I'll follow wherever you go.
Tomoya! Tomoya!
Hey, come on. It's no big deal, right? Still there is still. Come on. You don't have to cry.